بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، سيدي فخامة الرئيس جمهورية الصومال محمد عبد الله فرماجو، سيدي معالي رئيس مجلس البرلمان، سيدي معالي رئيس وزراء، أصحاب السعادة والمعالي، ضيوفنا الكرام، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم: من لا يشكر الناس لا يشكر الله. يشرفني أن أتقدم نيابة عن أسرة المرحوم الوالد عبد الرحمن عمر عثمان إنجنيري ريسو بخالص الشكر والامتنان إلى السيدي فخامة الرئيس، ولا خالص الشكر والامتنان إلى جمهورية فدرال الصومال. مدني بلح بينه مدنيال يا دمان شعب الصوماليا مركوهرا وان اسكا تحسينينا غيردي الله نحريسه تقم قالده انا قدومي قبل كبنادر ابهي عبد الرحمن عمر عثمان انجنيري ريسو. الله نحريسه ابو عبد الرحمن موسن كدبن او كليغا قوسكيسكا، لكن وحو كو غيريوده شعبك يا قرنك الصوماليت. مدني مدح بينه وحن امه الصوماليت كما مدح علينايا دعاء الله قرب تاقنية انتي وهسبتال كجيرا ايا مركي وقاريوذا كذب ايا ما تقوانا تاقنية انا ندعينه، فجزاكم الله خيرا. مدح الدولة وحن كما مدح علينايا دلالكي ايا جهدك ايكو بهيين ابهي. مدني مرحمينه الله نحريس ابو وحن وهانين شاقوين بدن كسو قابل دولده وحن ما حد قلنا يا دمان انتو نصور شقية آبهي انجني ريسو وكو قرب سي كرغيسان ان شاقدي سوكا قول قارو شعب قبل كالسماليا وحن اذن باقايا انان حل كيدا كسي ودان قولدي الشاقدي وعاسمدان كوذا آبهي سعاسمدان ونخل مت فمرت ما سنت مدني مرحبين. If you allow me, Your Excellency, Mr. President, just to express a few words in English. Okay. Today is not a day of sorrow, but rather one in which we should celebrate. What are we celebrating? We are celebrating the success and the legacy of my father. My father had a vision, and within this vision, he believed Mogadishu will one day become a place of peace, where we can easily roam and walk across the streets with no fear of anything. He also believed this country would be one of stability, in which that we can actively work with one another, actively engage with the community for the betterment of the Somali people. He also believed and had an idea of a vision of a 21st century progressive politics within Somalia. The idea of one man, one vote. The idea that all of us, we are citizens and we can engage within the Somali community. A lot of you throughout the past few days have told me that my father came to this country as a sacrifice and he left the family behind. I believe this was a sacrifice. I believe this was his duty, just as it is duty for all of us standing here today, to engage within our country for the betterment and the future of Somalia. Today I would like to honor his legacy by thanking all of his colleagues and the federal government of Somalia, with His Excellency Mr. President, His Excellency Mr. Speaker of the Parliament, and His Excellency Mr. Prime Minister, and all the ministers and colleagues of my father standing with me today. If you allow me just to share a story with you all. A lot of people informed me that when my father was here in this country, he would easily roam the streets, he would visit many community centres, and he would visit people in very scary locations. And whenever he was asked, why is it that you are not sitting behind your desk? Why is it that you are engaging outside with these people, with all the dangers around you? He always replied with the same story, that because of the Qadr Allah, the day of his death was always written, and nobody will take that away from him. So for this, he will not cower behind or sit behind any desk or behind his office, but instead, he will go with the Somali community, and he will be wherever he needs, wherever his job takes him, he will go there as well. And in this, I would like to thank the federal government of Somalia and all those around me for all the support they have given me. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.